So the difference between a dry contact and a solid state relay is whether we have moving parts or whether we have solid state switching. So here's an example of a dry contact relay. And I've taken the cover off so it's easier to see. When the relay pulls in, this part will pull down and close the contacts that are back here. So it doesn't always have to look like this. For example, Opto 22's dry contact relay looks like this, but on the side of it, it says output dry contact. This relay is only good to 10 volt amps, so I can't handle a heavy load. On a 120 volt line, it's only good to about a tenth of an amp. By comparison, if you have a solid state relay, there's no moving parts. So internally within this Opto 22 solid state relay, there's an electronic switch that turns the load on and off. And that can take different forms. This is also an example of a solid state relay. But mainly what's important is knowing how much current the load is going to draw. Solid state relays, it needs to draw at least a tenth of an amp of current on the load to switch properly. If it's a low current requirement, then the other dry contact relay from Opto would be good for less than a tenth of an amp.